Hi everyone, and thanks for watching CS Academy Computer Science Worldwide Educational Platform. This is Sabihuddin, now presenting you pre-release for October-November 2016. And the paper is Programs Problem Solving Skills and Programming, Paper Component 2, Syllabus Component 0478 and 2210 O-Level. Now we are going to study that how this pre-release will be solved. So now we are moving on to the next part. Now this is where you will start with the solution, and you can see the pre-release this time more or less similar to the previous one, that it requires you to just code it again. And the tasks which are given, you can see, I can just read the paper. In preparation for the examination, candidates should attempt the following practical tasks by writing and testing a program. The manager of the supermarket needs a program to record donations to charity. Record donation to charity means each customer has the choice of three charities to donate to, and 1% of their shopping bill will be donated to the chosen charity. The requirement is write and test a program for the manager. The three main points: your program must include appropriate prompts for the entry of data. The second point, error messages and other output need to be set out clearly. Then third one is the all variables, constants and other identifiers must have a meaningful names. So now you will need to complete these three tasks. Each task must be fully tested. So now we are going to take a look at task 1. The task 1 will show you that what to do. So we will be focusing task 1. You can see the contents of the task 1. It requires you for the names of three charities to be input and stored. This means that you will be storing the names in different arrays. And the charity, the point number 2, the charity names to be displayed with a number 1, 2 or 3 beside each name. That means it could be like a menu system where you will be given the choices 1, 2 and 3. If the user selects 1, 2 or 3, so accordingly the amount will be calculated and stored or set to the required charity types. Point number 4, the value of a customer's shopping bill to be entered. That means you will have to ask the bill's value from the user. Whenever he she selects the choice, the next question will come up with this option that enter the value of the bill, shopping bill. And then the fifth point is the donation to be calculated. After entering the bill, shopping bill's value, the donation must be calculated. Then the sixth task is three totals to be set to 0. That means you will be initializing the totals with 0, which will be ready to total each charity donation. That means each time when the charity is calculated, so the total must be calculated and store it separately. So now task number 2, what it requires, see what does the task 2 do. Record and total each donation. Record and total each donation. That means that you are going to see this thing, record and total each donation. That means this is for a customer shopping. That means for being a customer, that what you are going to input a charity choice of 1, 2 or 3. The input will be tested according to the value of the customer's shopping bill, and the calculation must be calculated and donated according to the choice entered. And you will be adding the donation to the appropriate total. So now see that the output, the names of the charity and the amount calculated or donated. In task number 3, you are required to do the totals so far. And what does it require you? That means it is extending task 2 to accept donations from more customers. That means the program is not limited to. That means it will keep on asking. That means it can use any loop, right? So donations from more customers, a charity choice of minus 1 or 0 to show the total so far. That means if you set 0 to terminate the program, or if you set 1 minus 1 to show the totals or terminate the program. So in any of the cases, either you can set to terminate the program. So the last messages will show you that display the charities names and the totals in descending order of the totals. That means you have to arrange them in descending order. Calculate a grand total of all three totals. That means you will be taking the values from different routines to the main or final output. Then you will be outputting the grand total donated to charity and the amount of the grand total. So this is the task which is required in all these three in this October-November pre-release for computer science 0478 and 2210. So you will see that how the tasks are explained and divided into different phases. So now keep on watching. See that you will see this task 1. It has been highlighted that what does task 1 do. First of all, you will be setting the names which are in green colors. I'm just going to explain that which the first part is the begin. Then you will initialize the variable, then integer, children, charity. That means this is a array mark, array representation. Then integer, that we are storing the total number of values in integer variable of children charity, then maid charity, then old age charity. So these names of three charities to be input and stored. Integer SBVC 0 initialized with 0, SBVM equals to 0, and SBVO equals to 0. The value of a customer's shopping bill to be entered three times separately. It has been separated. Then these are the counters which will count the total number of occurrences and will store accordingly in the array names given here. Then the donations to be calculated. Then integer C equals to 0, integer M equals to 0, integer O equals to 0. This is for charity, children. This is for maid charity, and this is for old age. Separate counters to move into an array. That means you will use these counters to keep on accessing arrays by using these counters separately on each turn. So now TDC, total donation for children, total donation for maids, and total donation for old age. Three totals to be set to 0, ready to total each charity donation. Then integer choice. I have declared here choice, CH, short for choice. A choice of 1, 2 or 3 to be entered to choose the charity. Right. So now integer GTDC equals to 0, grand total donated to charity. That means the grand total which is initialized with 0. Now the charity's names to be displayed with the number options 1, 2 or 3 beside each name. That means beside each name is 1, 2, 3 is printed. That means these printing statements will show you at the runtime. When you run the program, you will see these three options will display on screen, and you will choose the option, and according to the option corresponding to each parameter will run, and then it will function accordingly. Task number 2, record and total each donation. The types of charities entered, you will have to do this. That means the CH variable will take input as 1. So when it gets 1, this will start asking you to enter shopping bill value to SBV. That means shopping bill value for children. CC equals to SBVC multiplied by 0.1. That is, you are calculating 1%. This is 0.01, okay, this is 0.01, this is not 0.0.1, this is 0.01, right. C equals to C plus 1, children equals to C equals to C plus 1, this is the counter, children charity C equals to CC. That means you are accepting, calculating in CC, and then CC is going to be added to C, and C is the counter. With the help of counter, the children charity array will start accepting the values calculated in CC. Then you are going to calculate TDC equals to TDC plus children charity. This is the array name which is going to calculate the repetitive items according to the number of occurrences. Then you have GTDC equals to TDC. The first calculator calculating grand total starts over here. Then you are moving on to choice number 2. So again, this is also not 0.1, this is 0.01 value. So now input enter shopping bill value to SBVM, shopping bill value for maids, right. M equals to CM equals to SBVM multiplied by 0.01, then M equals to M plus 1, then maid charity, again array name, the M is the counter for running the or accessing the elements or accessing the depth of the array. Now CM is going to assign the stored value to made charity array. Now again TDM equals to TDM plus made charity with this M, and then GTDC equals to grand total donation for charity TDC plus, that means this is the main variable, this is first variable, and the second variable is going to add it, total donated donation for maids. So now choice number 3, when you enter option number 3, you will see that input enter shopping bill value to SBV0, OA old age equals to SBV0, again this is multiplied by 0.01 and the counter will start running, 0 equals to 0 plus 1, old age charity, 0 is the counter for accessing arrays which is old age charity, and then OA is assigning the values every time when it is calculated. Then TDO plus old age charity O, that means you are going to calculate the total of old age charity. Then again you are going to add this to GTDC equals to TDC plus TDM plus TDO, that means these three variables separately added to the master total, that is also known as grand total. So now this way you have solved these three tasks. Task number 3, now you have to show this way. You are calculating task number 3 this way, that means task 3 show the total so far, extend task 2 to accept input more donations from customers using infinite loop, it could be repeat or it could be while. That while ch not equals to, that means you are not equals to 0, or it could be not equals to minus 1. So now if it is not equals to minus 1 case, that means print 1, option number 1, that is children charity, right? The first part which they require, that means the show the display of these three names, and then the last one is the when minus 1 it receives, it will show the total charity, total status of the charity being calculated. So you will see print in descending order, 3 total age charity TDO, print total made charity TDM, print option number 1 total children charity TDC, and print grand total donated to charity is GTDC. So this way you have solved 3 tasks. So now I hope you will like this, and for the next part, or for the loop part, you will see in the next tutorial. Thanks for watching.